Hello, everyone. I'm Sheriff Wayne Ivey of the Brevard County Sheriff's Office, and you're watching Cooking Up Justice, the show where we highlight a local restaurant and their favorite dish, while also highlighting a criminal we are looking for or a crime prevention message from the Brevard County Sheriff's Office. Cooking Up Justice is not only a great way to introduce our community, some of the incredible chefs and specialized dishes in our area, but it's also another opportunity for our agency and community to work together to keep Brevard County a safe place to call home. So you ready? Let's cook up some justice. Today we're at Bagel 13 in Port St. John, 6725 US 1. Our friends Jesse and her team, even Jamie, are gonna show us how to make their signature sandwich. So let's go inside and see what they got for us today. So I'm with Jamie in the kitchen at Bagel 13, and she's gonna show us how to do their signature sandwich, the muffaletta. So I guess it started in New Orleans.
New Orleans inspired sandwich.
All right, so let's see how this works. So tell me what's on it. What's the ingredient?
It's salami, ham, and then provolone cheese, and then our house-made olive dressing.
All right, so you got a good portion of ham and then salami all around it?
Yeah, so we could cook every piece evenly.
How long does that usually take to cook the whole thing?
About 45 seconds.
So while she's cooking that up, we're gonna go ahead and cook up a little bit of Brevard County justice by asking our citizens to give us a hand solving one of our cases.
On Saturday, October 11th, 1980, the body of a black female was discovered by the roadway of Morrell Road near Barnes Boulevard in Rockledge. The victim is described as 20 to 25 years of age, approximately 5 foot 6 inches tall, weighing 120 pounds with reddish brown hair and brown eyes. The investigation revealed that months prior to the homicide, the victim had been arrested in Pinellas County under the name Joanne English. It was later discovered that the victim provided a false name, social security number, and date of birth in order to be quickly released from the detention center. The victim to date has not been identified and is classified as Jane Doe. Investigators have determined that the victim was driven to Brevard County from South Florida just prior to being murdered. Although the victim is not believed to be from Brevard County, she had knowledge of the area.
As always, we ask you if you have information about the case you just saw, call Crimeline at 1-800-423-TIPS, or you can give our sheriff's office a call, or you can send us an email. Either way, please help us out. We always need our citizens' help in solving some of our crimes. So Jamie, you just put some provolone cheese on top of it?
Yes, sir.
All right, now we're putting, what is that we're putting on it?
Water.
A little water?
Steaming, so all right. Help the cheese.
All right. You know, one of my favorite things about this is I get to test all the food, so
yeah.
I'm excited.
Me too.
We may have to do like 4 or 5 takes.
That's fine with me.
Yeah. Working out perfectly.
The more the merrier. And then I swing it over to the bagel. And then, this is our house-made olive dressing right here. And I get all that extra oil out.
Okay.
And I'll just put it right on top.
Wow.
And then close it up.
Signature sandwich here at Bagel 13. The muffaletta. So Jamie, first of all, thank you and thank Bagel 13 for all you guys do for us. You're tremendous partners with us and we love having that partnership. So this is actually my favorite part. This is where I get to test what you just made and tell our citizens how it is. So I'm gonna go ahead and take a good bite here. And
how do you like it?
Delicious, absolutely delicious. You know what? I'm gonna take another bite too, so. Come on down and see them at Bagel 13. As always, thank you for your incredible support of the Brevard County Sheriff's Office, and we'll see you next time on Cooking Up Justice.